It's me, Amy Taylor, and guess what? We are graced with the presence of a legend today, Don Cunningham, or should I say, Miss Steel City is with us today. Welcome today, Don.
Hello, Amy. How are you?
Very, very fine. You are Miss Steel City 2008. Is that correct?
That is correct.
Fantastic. What an honor.
I'm very happy to be here.
Was it an easy road for you?
It was not.
Talk to us about how this road began.
So, Bethel Park, I have known Amy Lee from probably 1998, 1999-ish. And we worked together. And she started to spend some time with me, helping me diet and train. And I just kept at it, and I kept at it, and I kept at it. And in 2008, I decided to take it to the next level, and I did my first natural bodybuilding competition.
And won it.
And I won it.
You took first place in your very first bodybuilding competition.
I did, yes.
Let's not sell yourself short. Talk to the viewers at home. What kind of a person were you back in 1998 when I met you? And what was your lifestyle choices?
So they were not very good. There's a lot of alcohol involved, bar time, drinking, partying, per se. Bar food, pizza, not eating well. So we cleaned that up, did a lot of cardio. It actually took me a year to lose 20 pounds because I did it properly. So it did not come off quickly, and it was a lot of hard work that first year.
Now, I remember back when we very first started working out together. Yeah. I was working out a lot at the gym. Wasn't married, didn't have kids, had lots of free time, so I worked at the gym all the time. That was like my playground, so to speak. And one day you came up to me and you said, "Can I tag along?"
I did. And exactly. And honestly, this is Amy, okay? Bethel Park, what you see on TV, this is Amy. This is how Amy's been forever.
During our tag along, sessions, talk to me about how you dipping your toe into the water of working out started for you, because I can remember quite vividly our experiences together, and I'm hoping that you could share with the viewers at home how that affected you.
At first, it was hard. It was very difficult to go to the gym, not being in shape per se.
Mentally or physically?
Mentally and physically.
Yeah. Explain to them why. How? Like what you.
I was uncomfortable. I was depressed. I had low self-esteem, and working out helped with the depression. Helped with the low self-esteem. It doesn't take anything away completely, but it does help. And if you talk to any therapist or medical doctor, they'll tell you that when you work out, it releases, you know, the happy endorphins, the dopamine and serotonin. So it did help me with that. And when I don't work out, I had COVID, so that was a really rough time because I couldn't work out and I couldn't do cardio and I was depressed. I fell into depression again. So getting back into everything in the gym really helps.
So when you first started off at the gym, is it safe to say that you were uncomfortable in your own skin?
I was, extremely.
And I remember how self-conscious you were because you kept saying, "Everybody's looking at me. I don't belong here. I don't feel comfortable." And I says, "Well, you have as much right to be here as anybody else, and you're going to keep coming." And we were like two peas in a pod. And every day we would go in and we would spend about how long each day at the gym? Tell the viewers at home, this is all honesty. This is for
probably between 2.5 to 3 hours. Yeah. Because again, we were young, you know, that was many years ago.
I would say we spent about 3 to 5 hours at the gym every day.
Yes.
Because it was an hour or so in just cardio. And then we did the weights and we did the cardio. Training and everything else. Yeah.
The cardio and abs. Always with the abs. Always with the abs.
You always got to end with the abs, you know?
Yeah.
But also, I want to talk to you about you had. And you mentioned the depression from your lifestyle choices, and it just spiraled you down, and working out helped you with that. But you also had very severe asthma.
I did.
And I want you to talk to the viewers at home about your asthmatic condition, how that affected your workouts, and how that is now. This is so important.
Luckily, over the past, 10, 15 years, the medications have gotten so much better. But back, you know, early 90s, 80s, even late 90s, it was all prednisone. And prednisone causes weight gain, and prednisone causes depression, and also acne. So it was still hard to, you know, try to manage working out, have the allergies and the asthma kick in, then go on this medication. So it was never an easy road. There was always some obstacle, but I kept going and overcoming. And it's really important, and it helps to have a workout partner, you know, somebody that can, you know, help you be accountable. One thing I remember is we went to the gym, which back then was Bally's. Am I allowed to say that? Yeah. And I came home, and Amy had called me, and she said, "What are you doing?" I told her I was eating, and she said, "What are you eating?" And I said, "Chicken." And she says, "And?" I said, "With some cheese." She said, "You can't have cheese. Why are you eating cheese? You can't eat cheese right now. You're on a diet." So I scraped the cheese off my chicken breast and ate my chicken with some broccoli. So accountability is very important.
That's right. That's exactly right. And when you have a workout buddy, and one of you is going to the gym, and they kind of make the other one feel guilty, "Well, why aren't you going to the gym with me? Well, can you come to the gym with me?" And it gives you a little workout buddy, a little workout partner kind of thing.
Yes.
But regarding the asthma, I remember specifically, and I'm going to tell the viewers about this, we were working out, we were doing squats on the Smith machine. Do you remember this?
I do.
And your asthma was so bad, and you were a chain smoker.
I didn't chain smoke. I did smoke.
She had really bad asthma. And we were on the Smith machine. We were doing squats. And I remember she could not breathe. And she looked at me and she goes, "Take the rack off." We did a lot of weight at the time. We were working our legs. And she goes, "Take the rack off." And I remember I re-racked it. And your face got white and you go, "I can't breathe." You said, "You need me to walk you out." Do you remember this?
I do.
And I walked you out of Bally's. And we sat down on the curb, and you put your head down between your knees, and you could not breathe. And I had my arm around you, and I'm like, wow. And to go from that, not being able to breathe, not being able to do a set on the Smith machine, to miss freaking Steel City 2008, all I can say is you've come a long way, baby. You came a long way.
I have, and I've also been... Not to be cliche, but I have also been very blessed. I've had a lot of strong women in my life, a lot of strong friends, people that have pushed me, that have supported me, obviously Amy being one of them. It all started with her. I tell everybody that all the time when they ask. But my trainer is, she was also a bodybuilder, so she's very positive. And I've just met a lot of great women along the way, and, you know, just keep at it.
And that's a great message to get across, that we as women have the strength, and we have the power, and we have the ability to raise one another up. We can lift up our sisters. There's no need to tear each other down. There's no need to revel in each other's demise or the suffering. What a strong society we would be if we as women rose one another up and helped one another. Right?
Yeah, I agree.
Yeah. You know. So between me, your trainer, your sister, other, you know, strong women in your life, they helped you. Correct. How's your asthma now?
It's better. It's under control because I haven't smoked in many, many years.
That's right. That was one of your lifestyle choices.
It was.
You changed. Did you do it cold turkey, or you gradually went off?
I gradually didn't work for me. I had to go cold turkey.
Yeah, I remember.
Yeah.
Cold turkey.
I had to go cold turkey.
And so you said, you know what? If I want to be on this cardio machine as long as you are, Amy, I need to start by stopping smoking.
Correct.
That's exactly right. And then you changed your diet.
I did.
Accountability is a lot.
Yes.
So you changed your diet. You started working out more.
I did.
And I see you have a book in front of you. Explain to the viewers at home what this book is and what it means to you.
So I've actually used this BodyMinder journal, plug, since we started working out. And this is great. This is my favorite one, and I wanted to pull my old ones out from 98, but I can't find them. This one's actually from 95, but you can put all your sets in there and everything. And if you want your diet, I log food. I've always just hand wrote my food down, or now I just use an app, but it's nice to look back, you know, and see where you were at and how far you've come. So I just like this, keep my little fitness journals.
And that goes back to accountability as well.
It does.
if you know you have to write it down and look at that or show someone, maybe you won't eat that cheese sandwich or the ice cream right. or the milkshake or whatever.
Right.
So if you know if you have to write it down, maybe you won't put it in your mouth.
Correct. You know about right before you bite.
That's exactly right.
You know, if you write it down and you see actually what, oh my goodness, you may not put it in your mouth.
Mm-hmm. You know, so. And you keep track of all your reps, all your sets, all the exercises that you do to track your progress.
Correct.
So you can look back and say, well, I did 8 reps of 15, now I'm in 8 sets of, what was the most you ever bench pressed?
Probably 125.
Bench press 125. So. That's amazing. That's amazing. You're amazing.
I'm the small girl.
You're amazing. How tall are you?
I'm 5 foot.
How much did you weigh when you were competing?
I'm small, so I only weigh, when I compete, and when anybody competes, not just me, but when you see the bodybuilders on stage, bodybuilders and physique athletes are the leanest. So when I did the competition, I was 105 pounds.
What would you say you were when we first started working out?
140, and it took me a year to get down to 120. I say 120, but it was actually 122. It took a year.
Mm-hmm. Because anybody who's everybody who knows the right way is through diet and exercise to lose weight. These crash diets, these fad diets are not healthy. You're just going to end up putting on the weight right back real quick. Am I right?
You're correct.
You need to do things slow and steady and do things the right way. Diet and exercise is key.
It is.
You know, abs are made in the kitchen.
They are. And as women, we can't rely on the scale. Because a woman's weight just fluctuates way too much.
Yeah.
Just with our hormones and salt and water. And I mean, you just need to, you know, how you look, how your clothes fit, how you feel. So I scale tend to stay away from maybe once a week or once every other week now.
I never get on the scale.
Yeah.
Because if you get on the scale and you don't like that number, you're going to self-sabotage. You're going to end up binge eating or eating something and getting frustrated or getting in your own head, essentially. And you just want to keep positive vibes, and I don't even get on that scale. Because guess what? That's just a number. How do you feel?
Right.
How are your clothes fitting on you? Right?
Mm-hmm.
You want to be comfortable in your own skin.
Yes.
And that's why I call my show Healthy, Fit, and Strong, because I don't think anybody should be skinny. I think she should be your healthiest, your fittest, and your strongest.
Right, and you know, bodybuilders or fitness models are on stage, they're not their healthiest. You know, you're depleted, you're probably hungry. You know, there's always, you know, somebody, you know, that maybe the diet isn't as hard for them, but for the most part, you're hungry and thirsty. You know, it's a long road.
And crabby.
Know. And crabby.
You were very crabby every day. You'd start the conversations off with, I'm very crabby.
I was hungry and tired.
That's right. So it actually affected your psyche, too.
It does, yes.
You became a different person while you were training and doing all that.
Correct.
And you would do a 4 or a 5 a.m. workout every day.
4.
Explain to the viewers at home what time you would wake up and what would be an average day in the life of training to be Miss Steel City.
I had to do cardio. So I would do my cardio in the morning. I would get up at 4 because I work. I have a 9-to-5 or 8-to-5 job, so I have to do everything before work. So I would get up, do my cardio for an hour, and if I had time, I'd do a quick workout, go back home, get my food ready, get ready for work, go to work. Sometimes I would like go out at lunch and go for a walk, just a quick walk because I just needed, you know, for the competition's sake. and then at night, I would do my weight training. So I was essentially at the gym a lot during, you know, getting ready for a show. Now I just try to get up in the morning because it makes me feel good. When I get up early, for me, when I get up early and I walk on the treadmill or I go for a walk outside or I do the bike, it's a sense of accomplishment. I've already accomplished something that day. You know, I'm outside, I'm walking, it's quiet, you know, and you're out there and you're doing something. Everybody else is asleep. You're out there and you're getting it done. You're getting ahead of the game. So that's kind of why I like the morning workouts.
What would you say was the most challenging part of your training regimen?
Eating. I love food.
Mm-hmm. So eating the specific foods at the specific times of day was the
yes.
most challenging. And I want you to talk to the viewers at home about the story you told me about how you food shopped. You would put your head down.
Oh.
You would not breathe because you couldn't smell the smells that were in the Giant Eagle.
I forgot.
You would make a beeline for the frozen chicken bags.
I would. I forgot about that.
And you would literally run back to your car.
I was so traumatized. No, I wasn't.
Because there's so many temptations around.
There are. And a friend of mine was also trying to lose some weight. And she told me a story where she would like pick up a pizza and just walk around the store with it. And then she would go put it back. But yeah, I would have to be very focused when I went into the store and just get my chicken or get my vegetables. Like
she couldn't make eye contact. She had to look down. She couldn't even smell the smells. She had to go in, get what she needed, and get out of Dodge.
Yes, because I love to eat.
I can't tell you, because we as friends would celebrate birthdays together. Hers is in the fall, mine's in the spring, so we'd get together 2 times a year, celebrate birthdays. She missed years of birthday celebrations because she simply could not eat out. The food that's prepared out in restaurants is made with butter rather than oil or has sauces or, you know, it's not as healthy as what she would make at home. Or you know the ingredients that you're putting in your own food. You don't know what the chef behind closed doors is putting in. So she just wouldn't come out with us. She just stayed in her own little hobbit hole, trained, disciplined, mentally, physically focused, eye on the prize, eye of the tiger, and came away a winner.
And I don't know how I did it. Because now I've tried, I've competed since then, and I've tried some other ones and tried to get ready for another show, and my discipline eludes me now. It's a chocolate.
What made you want it so bad that first time? Like, what was your focus?
I think it was just a lot of input I was getting from people.
Positive input?
Yes. You know, and I made a lot of friends at the gym. Females that competed, and they looked so amazing, and they're like, oh, you can do this, it's easy, you know. Well, it's not easy, but just having that positive, you know, why don't you do this, why don't just give it a try, you know, you can always start it, and if you don't like it, you can finish it, but you can't, you know, if you don't do it, then you didn't try.
What did you win by becoming Miss Steel City 2008.
You got these fine trophies.
Wow, you got those fine trophies. And the plaque as well?
Yeah, the plaque was for best poser, so that means
you were best poser too!
Yeah, that means my routine was the best. And then
you're the best?
No, I don't like to say that. And so there, when you do your first show, there's novice, which means you've never competed before. There's open, which means you could have competed before, but then you're in a class which is open, which means you have and have not competed. and then for bodybuilding and physique, posing. So that's when you go out and do your minute and 30-second routine to music, your poses to music, and then the best poser wins. When you get to the pro level, you get cash prizes. The first top three get money.
So both those giant trophies were won in the first competition.
In the plaque.
And the plaque for best poser.
The plaque, yes.
Now what about that ring that you're sporting there?
This ring that I'm sporting is my Ms. Steel City 2008.
Just the first place winner gets it?
Yes. So the man, Mr. Steel City, and Ms. Steel City get that.
And what is that? Is that an onyx in there with gold?
I think it is an onyx. Mm-hmm. And it all depends on the promoter of the show. So this show was put on by Stacy Longo of Sunshine Fitness, and she puts this show on every year, the Mr. and Ms. Steel City. And, you know, sometimes she does rings, sometimes she does, you know, other things.
Oh,
it's just the promoter, whatever the promoter wants to do. So you don't always get trophies. Sometimes there are swords.
Oh, okay.
They'll do swords.
Oh, I like the trophies.
Sometimes they'll just
do
the cups.
Looks just like you, Dawn.
Oh, gosh. She's a little taller.
I want you to talk to the viewers at home about the competition suits that you have to wear.
So the suits are...
Could I go to Target and buy a bathing suit and wear one?
It is not a bathing suit. They're special posing suits.
Explain to them what it is.
They're special posing suits. They're handmade. You have to take your measurements. Can't remember the weeks. But you have to give the suit, the lady that makes the suit, enough time to put the suit together. So you have to get your measurements, get them out to her, and it's very small material. So if you're interested or you want to see more about them, if you just go into your internet search and type competition suits, you'll see the different ones that come up. For figure and physique, the suits have to cross in the back like this. For the bikini competitions, it's a bikini, but it's not a bikini. There's rhinestones, and you know, they're very pretty and feminine.
How much did your suit cost?
When I got my suit, I only paid $500 for it because it was cheap.
It's a bargain. How much do normal suits go for?
They can go for between $1,200 and $1,700, depending on the amount of crystals in them.
And how many suits do you wear per competition? Just one?
We wore two, because for prejudging, you want more of a plain suit because you don't want any glitter or crystals to take away from your physique, because that's prejudging. And that's when the judges make their choices. Like, so after that initial prejudging, it's already made. You know who the winner is, you know, and the placements and everything. The evening show and then the routines, that's when we put on our sparkly suits and do our routines. They've switched things now, though. Because the shows were so long, it's basically boom, 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 it's done. So we don't really change. There's a lot of competitors that don't change suits anymore.
So the average cost of a suit is between $1,200 and $1,700, and sometimes you have to wear two of them.
Yes, but now it depends where you get them. You know, you get what you pay for. You can get a cheaper suit. You can get a suit for a couple hundred dollars, and now there's also sites where you can rent a suit.
Oh.
Yeah.
A used suit.
Yeah.
Mm. Question. I'm very curious to let the viewers at home know, how much did you invest in that very first, I see the look on your face, on that very first competition between
thousands.
Your special foods, your supplements, your training, your suits, your tanning, your posing, because you had to pay someone to train you how to pose.
My trainer, yes.
What would you say, just give us a ballpark figure of how much it cost you to compete in your very first competition?
I mean, if you're going to count food and everything.
Well, just special foods. Food you wouldn't ordinarily
eat.
That's
what I mean. Because it's just, you know, the chicken, the chicken breast, the
eggs.
And
keep in mind, when you eat healthy, it's always more expensive.
It is.
There's a reason people that eat on the dollar menu look like a dollar and not a million bucks.
Exactly. I mean, with everything, if you're going to throw in the suits, the amount it costs.
Throwing it all in. Give me a grand total.
Oh, my gosh.
And then we won't let your husband hear this. How much did
this
you spend?
This was before I was married.
Right, of course.
Probably close to, probably $3,000.
Really? I thought it was more.
Probably is.
No, I know what it was, and it was more than that, but we'll go with $3,000.
I mean, just the suit.
I know.
You know, and then when you, the gym memberships, I had two gym memberships.
Right, I remember.
Because I work downtown, and if I were to wait to go home to work out, I'd be too tired.
Right.
So I had
you would have to work out at the one gym, and then the mornings you work out at another gym where you'd run and you'd need special shoes. And so you're going to say conservative estimate would be
$3,000. Yes, conservative.
I see you brought a picture with you today, and it's of us two goofballs. This is just a random photo a couple years ago. It was in my backyard.
That was after a show. So.
Right. Well, that's how she looked. She looked amazing. Now, I see you're wearing a barbell necklace. Can you explain to the viewers at home what is the significance of that? Because I understand it has a special meaning, too.
It does. So I came across a website called Shields of Strength, and they make fitness-related jewelry with spiritual messages. So this one is the Philippians, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. And my trainer, Stacy, has always said that. And so I bought this because it makes me remember that, and it makes me think of her. So that's why it's special to me.
That's a really, really nice message. I am so proud of you for all of your accomplishments and everything you've been through. You are such a strong young lady. You are such a good friend. Is there anything else that you wish to leave the viewers at home, a little message or words of wisdom to end?
I'm just going to go back on what you said earlier about lifting each other up. You did something, you know, out of the kindness of your heart, or, you know, because you'd like to train. You train. You're a personal trainer. That's what you do. That's what you've always done. And you took it upon, you know, you trained me. Because you said yes, and you helped me lose that weight, I kept going. Because you had always positive words, and you were always there, I kept going. So none of this would have probably happened without that first step. So, you know, like you said, we have to lift each other up.
And did you want to talk about the speech that you made?
My very first, well, before I did my routine at Miss Still City, or the Still City show, they ask how everything, you know, how you began and what started your fitness journey, and I said that, and I said, thank you, Amy Lee, because without you, none of this would have happened.
That's right.
In front of everybody. They all know.
That's right.
They all know.
And you are a tremendous friend.
Thank you.
You are a tremendous athlete. You are a tremendous, strong woman. I applaud you. It has been our pleasure to spend the time here with Dawn Cunningham, Miss Steel City 2008 today, Bethel Park, Healthy, Fit, and Strong. I'm Amy Taylor. Thank you, Dawn.
Thank you. Appreciate it. Thank you, Bethel Park.
Dawn is an insurance agent. She's been weight training for 7 years and trains at World's Gym of Pittsburgh and Valley's downtown Pittsburgh. This is her first competition. She'd like to thank you, her family, and friends for support, and special thanks to Amy Lee Taylor for starting it all. Special thanks also to Stacey Longo for helping her through this journey. Contestant number 27, Dawn Lagama.